So, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
The reason I call you in today is I just wanted to ask you a few questions, guys, and discuss this matter regarding the gift and giving. First of all, let me ask you, Pierre. You have been here for quite a long time. And
8 years already.
And you haven't been promoted since then, huh?
I love my position.
Alright, so can you please tell me the current situation of the company?
Okay. Currently, we don't have any financial crisis. We are doing okay, but not that good because we have a very slow business. And I know that there are three major national big companies just stepping in this area, and we also have to deal with the other 9 similar size of company. So I would say the competition in this area is very intense. And recently, I also discovered that the morale in the sales team is kind of low due to the hardship or difficulty they may experience in this field. So I would think we need to do something to stimulate or at least maintain their satisfaction. Right, Andrew?
Andrew, let me ask you something, man. How are the sales rep working at the moment, and how competitive is the industry?
It's lethal out there. You know, with the downward economy and everything, our competitors are all trying to steal our market share. So it's pretty tough out there. It's pretty bad.
Who used to pay for the gifts before? The company or you, the sales reps?
I think the company should pay for it, right?
The company. I mean, why?
No, I ask who used to pay for it. You know, what do you think about now? The company used to pay before I come here for the gifts?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah?
They used to pay for it. It's a tradition. It's our culture. The company should pay for it, right?
I wouldn't pay for the gifts myself. I mean, that's just absurd. I mean, if I needed to spend money for the company, I think I should go out there and look for another job.
You wouldn't like it, no?
Definitely not.
All right, let me just go over a few facts before we can go further into this issue. You already know that some customers may see it as bribery, giving out gifts. And it always depends on the value of the gift. It has to be logically priced and tastefully selected. Wine is a good deal. Even if people do not drink it, they can keep it on their shelves. What about the prospecting companies? Companies that we are currently doing business with them, or companies that we want them to be our clients, should we give them gifts?
Well, for my opinion, I think gift is a respect to our customers. We make them happy. I think we only giving gift for the existing clients, right?
Yeah, I don't think giving gifts to prospecting companies is a good idea. I think that's more sort of bribery than no.
Okay. So we only send gifts to customers who already established relationships with us.
That's correct.
Right. Okay. So we all agree that, yes, we would like to continue sending gifts once a year, every Christmas.
Of course.
I think that's a good idea.
And I spoke to you guys individually, and both of you said yes, and I understand that this is how the company works. I cannot really change everything. I can change a few aspects, but this thing is supposed to stay like this. I understand that we built the relationship with customers, we strong relationships, so I guess it's a good idea. $25,000, that's a big cost to the company, that's a big expense, but let me just do something here. 900 accounts, we have 11 sales reps, right?
Yes.
So approximately $25 for each customer. But you don't have to bother about these details, guys. Don't get confused. I will just figure things out, and I will let you know as soon as possible. Let's go to the next question. How do you think are you going to customize the gifts? How do you guys want to do that?
Well, I currently hold about approximately 80 accounts, and 15 of them are actually major active accounts.
80 accounts, you said?
Yes.
Okay.
And then approximately 65 of them are less active. And to my opinion, I think the 65 accounts, I don't want to think too much into what kind of gifts I want to get them. So I think I want to continue the tradition of just giving them the wines that we previously ordered. But for the 15 major accounts, I think I want to come up with something a little more extravagant and to show my appreciation for their business.
I like that. So in other words, big accounts can be customized accordingly, and no time is to be wasted on the smaller ones. Just wines, basically. So the smaller accounts, we just send them the wines, and then you can customize the big accounts. You can just send them cigars or other things, depending on the budget you have, right?
Right, and of course, at my discretion, but at your approval.
Of course. I will consider everything you said, and I just want to make sure that everything given away to customers is ethical, legal, and appropriate to the situation. Upon analyzing the specific accounts, depending on how much business we do with them, we're going to decide, you are going to guys decide what gifts to give them, and then you just let me know and I approve it. So I think we're on the same page for now.
Right.
I would like to thank you for your time, and I will come up with further details on this matter later on.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Sounds good.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Bye.
Dear President and employees of Concord Oil, it has been 2 years already, and I'm fully satisfied with this company. Although people have thought and still think that sending out gifts is a bribery, I strongly oppose them from my own experience here at Concord Oil. The company's sales increased by 16%, and nothing hurt our integrity and the morale within our company because our policy was realistic, functional, and successful. We all like being here, and we all make money. Congratulations to all of us, and keep up the good work. And remember, every dollar counts, and the only money generator is money.